107.5 WBLS. Welcome inside the Quiet Storm, baby. Yep, we are ready to make it last as long as we possibly can make it last tonight. We're inside of Confessions of Love, and joining me tonight, ladies, is the man that you have been missing for quite some time, and he is back with us tonight to sit down to introduce us to a brand new project that he's working on. In addition to music, he is now adding another title to his illustrious titles. We know him, of course, as a singer, songwriter, producer. He definitely is an entrepreneur, definitely an entrepreneur in many ways. But now he's an author. Of course, he's a radio personality, and author is the next dimension for Brother Keith Sweat. It is an honor and a pleasure, brother, to finally sit down and talk with you after all of these years.
Thank you for having me, Lenny. I appreciate that.
Man, my
great introduction, man.
And my pleasure, brother. You know, in talking with Keith just a little while ago, I really understand thoroughly now, brother, how you did so well prior to you even starting your career. I know you were a commodities broker on Wall Street at Payne Webber, if I'm not mistaken.
Payne Webber, Prudential Base. I started at in Comex, then went to work for Prudential Base, and then went to Payne Webber.
See, a lot of folks don't really understand the history of this, brother. You know, he's more than just music. He is a businessman. He is an entrepreneur. And he was explaining his plan of action and what's happening and what's going to take place. And brother, I wish you all the future blessings that is continuing to shower your way.
Thank you, my brother. I appreciate
that's
going to
be
that.
A good thing. But let's talk about this brand new book. The book is called Make It Last Forever, The Do's and Don'ts. First of all, it's being presented by a young lady who we pretty much know very well when it comes to classy erotic. And that's Zane. So tell me how you came across Zane and how this whole project came together.
Well, I met Zane through my girl from Sister to Sister.
Oh, Jamie.
Jamie. Yeah. And she was interested in us working together and doing a book. And, you know, I wasn't trying to do the erotic thing. I had to go.
Right, I understand.
I had to stay in my lane, baby.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So my lane was just talking about relationships. And seems like a lot of people are writing books about relationships, but because I've sung the songs, I felt that it would be perfect for me to do a book like this. So, and that's how it all happened.
Now, you cover so many spectrums. We're going to try to cover a lot of the areas that you cover. I want to talk about the chapter that deals with baggage, because going into a relationship, especially a new relationship, and you may have come out of a bad relationship, or you may have had a series of bad relationships.
Right.
Baggage.
Right.
How do you not bring baggage into a new relationship?
Well, it's hard to not bring it, but you shouldn't bring it into a new relationship. Because what happens when you have old baggage and you bring it into a new relationship, or you should not get into a relationship unless you're ready to leave that old baggage aside. Because what happens is a lot of people get into a relationship and have not really gotten over their old relationships, and they're bringing that old baggage into that new relationship, which ends up destroying the new relationship.
And you had said in the book that you also have jumped from one relationship into a next at one point in time, but then you stopped doing that.
Well, because we all feel like the best way to get over something is getting into something else. I've done it, and I'm quite sure there's a lot of other people who have done it.
I'm sure,
so,
too.
Sometimes we feel like, okay, well, I'll get into this and that'll help me forget about this person over here.
And it really doesn't
work. And it doesn't work.
Keith Sweat is his name. He is the heartthrob, as you know, ladies. 212-545-1075. Let's do a one-to-one tonight. Are you going through a relationship problem? We're going to put the guru to work. He's the new relationship guru. We're going to put him to work tonight. Give us a call if you're going through something challenging in your relationship, and let's see if Keith can kind of let you see the light at the end of the tunnel. All right, let's do it tonight. And look at us online at WBLS.com. Click on the Quiet Storm page.
Something that you told me stayed in my head all night long. You wanted me to love you when you said. Yeah.
hate if I should lose your love for any reason at all. Then let my record show I gave you all.
Thank you.
107.5 WBLS. Thanks for watching us online. We really do appreciate it. Well, this man doesn't need any introduction, obviously. You know, he has a face that everyone knows. It's Keith Sweat. He is definitely in the building tonight of The Quiet Storm. And he is an author. You heard me talk about it. This is the brand new book. It is officially in stores as we speak. Make It Last Forever, The Do's and Don'ts. I trust, my brother, that you have been through a few situations in life.
I've been through the do's and I've been through the don'ts.
So when you go through the don'ts, how do you not repeat the don'ts? What's your
rule? I mean, it's a mature process. You know, as we young, there's certain things we get into that we just don't care. As we get older and realize there's certain things that we don't care about that we used to care about,
yeah,
we change.
True.
In so many ways. And I think it's a growing process. A relationship is a growing process. Once you get into a relationship, you and that young lady or that young lady and that man, they have to grow together in that relationship.
But have you noticed this? Because I have noticed this. Just because you're an adult doesn't really dictate the fact that you're mature.
There you go.
That's a problem.
I know quite a few people, to be honest with you, that are in relationships, even though they're older. I mean, you would think they were kids in that relationship.
Right.
Believe me. I mean, they go back and forth like
kids.
Like kids. They don't know. They talk at each other and not to each other. And that's very important in a relationship, that you talk to your mate and not at your mate.
At what point, when you feel that it gets to, or do you ever feel it gets to a point where they must seek professional help if they want to make it last forever?
Sometimes it has gotten to that point, but both people have to want to go seek professional help, because sometimes, you know, it takes an outsider to bring awareness to what you're doing in your relationship that's going wrong. You might not be able to see it. Your mate might not be able to see it, but an outsider can say, hey, well, these are the things that I see are happening in your relationship that you really need to fix.
Yeah. His name is Keith Sweat. You know, I want to go to the love lines and have you talk one-on-one. So 212-545-1075. Hit us up. Let's grab a call, Janelle. How are you tonight?
I'm good, Lenny.
That's good. Who's this?
My name is Edna, and I'm calling from the Bronx.
Okay, Edna. I want you to say hello to Keith Sweat.
Yo, what's up, Keith?
Hey, Edna. How you doing, baby? What's going
on
with you?
I'm pretty good just for right now. I'm a little nervous.
Don't be, baby. Don't be nervous. Let me calm you down, girl.
That laugh.
Let me calm you down, boo. You don't have no reason to be nervous.
Okay.
So what's your question or comment for Keith?
Okay, my question. Hi, Lenny. How's it sound? I'm looking at you on my smile.
What's up, man? Okay.
Okay, my question is this. I'm a woman over 45. My husband died last year from a coma and two strokes, right?
Sorry to hear that.
Now, I know what Keith is saying. You know, give time, time. So I'm giving time, and nothing is really falling through. But I know not to put the relationship out there after my husband just died, because I'm just really coming off a relationship for my husband. But I'm just saying, I know not to, you know, put the old baggage into the new bag.
Mm-hmm.
But it's hard. It's just hard. I don't want the dating scene. I don't want that. I don't know what I want, but I know I don't want the dating scene. We're going to a club, meeting somebody, you know, things of that caliber. So I don't know what to do. What to do, Keith Sweat?
Well, you know, time heals all wounds. Uh-huh. And unfortunately, your situation is, I'm so happy to say, not common for a lot of people. You know, your husband dying, death is a situation that you cannot, you know, you don't know when it's coming. And for you, I understand what your situation is. You don't want to just jump into another situation, but you're still hurting from the passing of your husband. So, I mean, time heals all wounds, and all I can do is tell you, you have to wait till you heal, because you haven't healed thoroughly yet, you know, and you do, even though it's easier said than done, you definitely have to heal before you get into something else, because it still sounds like you're still recovering from the passing of your husband.
Trust me, Keith, I'm putting all blockers on me all around. You know what I'm saying? I'm not letting any avenues come upon me where, you know, they're gonna attack, you know, like attack a woman.
Right, right.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
I truly understand what you're saying.
I remember I was at a club one time and I was surrounded by nothing but men, but my husband was in the hospital, and I knew not to cross those boundaries with no other man.
Right.
But I was still afraid. You know, I knew my husband was going to pass. Mm-hmm. I knew he was.
Right.
And I knew I couldn't do nothing about it. But I was just scared. They were trying to talk to me, what have you, but I was just like, nah, I'm not.
Well, when it's when it, I'm a firm believer that when God has something for you, he'll bring it to you.
Yes.
And you need to just stand still, you know.
Stand still?
Stand still, baby.
Okay, and do me, right?
And do you.
I will, y'all.
And stay prayed up and allow God to bring you what he has
Definitely,
in store for you.
I try to go to the hall every Sunday with my son.
There you go. Well, you're doing your thing, baby girl.
Thanks
okay,
for calling, Linda.
Thank you.
All right, take care of yourself.
Y'all have a nice evening.
You too.
Okay, bye-bye.
Which brings me to another interesting point that I want to bring up. In terms of what is a healthy time frame, and I know it may vary, Keith, from situation to situation, but what would you feel a healthy time frame is when you're coming out of a relationship before you get into another one?
Well, I mean,
if you have to generalize.
It's hard to put a time on something right. like that. It depends on the individual. I mean, some people get over things quicker than other people get over things. I just think that you know when you're ready to get into something totally different. You know, when you're not thinking about that other person. I think the time frame is when you're no longer thinking about that other person. If that person still enters your mind while you're with another man or dating another man, then you know the time is not now. It's not the time.
Exactly. I got you. We're inside the Quiet Storm tonight. You can call us up at 212-545-1075. Let's go to line one. I think Colleen is on line one. Colleen, thanks for locking in with us tonight. Welcome inside the Quiet Storm. Say hello to Keith Sweat, Colleen.
Colleen, how you doing, babe?
Hello.
Hi, Colleen.
Hello.
Hi. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Good. I have a relationship situation that has me so stressed out, and I'm hoping that you guys can give me some advice.
Well, Keith can, because he's the guru. He's the relationship guru. That's his new title for tonight. So,
well, I mean, I got Lenny helping me out. There's a whole lot of women going to be calling in tonight, so he got my
this
back.
I think it's going to be a good one for you. My boyfriend of 5 years relationship recently told me about a year ago that he loves me. I'm such a wonderful person, but he's falling out of love with me. And after talking, we said we were going to try it, you know, to keep the relationship going. And when I recently asked him, he said he's not there yet. So I feel like I'm bending over backwards, trying to do everything to make him fall back in love with me. But now I'm getting angry because I feel like I'm doing everything and he's still not there after a year. What am I supposed to do?
Well, first of all, you're supposed to turn your... you must be outside. Are you outside somewhere?
I was driving, but I pulled over.
I can tell. Okay. I was going to say that's number one.
Right.
Pull over. Let me talk to you quick. No, but seriously, I think, you know, when someone says they're falling out of love with you, and I've been there before, that means you're not dating. You know, before you got into the relationship, probably you and him dated, y'all courted each other, y'all did a lot of things that couples do before they get into the relationship. What normally happens when people are in a relationship, they forget about all the things that happen to bring them into that relationship. I mean, the things that made you want that man, the things that made that man want you. I tell people this all the time. Don't wear the headband to bed because it's not sexy to me. And I understand women love to keep their hair right for the next morning.
Right, right.
A man likes to see what he saw when he first met you, and vice versa. If a brother's wearing gym shorts to bed and tube socks, that's not sexy. So you got to keep the fire in the relationship. And most people do not know how to keep that fire in the relationship. So if he's saying he's falling out of love with you, he's probably falling out of love with the things he saw in you when he first met you. And those things you have to bring back. You have to keep it sexy in the bedroom. You have to talk to him, not at him. You just have to, You know, basically act like you just met this guy and it's like, baby, dang, I'm in love with you. Or I'm impressed. I want to get to know you. Act like you just meeting him for the first time and start giving him cards and doing the things, you know, that won him over in initially.
And you know what, Colleen, if I'm going to add just a little bit to what Keith has said, because Keith hit all the sound points. But what I would say, and I don't know if Keith, you might agree or disagree with this, I would say she needs to just sit down with this dude first and have a one-to-one, heart-to-heart conversation
about
where their relationship is.
Yeah, because there might be certain things that he's really feeling, and maybe you're not giving him the opportunity to express those things. Once you, I mean, there might be a lot going on with him, and allow him to open up without you getting, like you said, I'm getting mad, I'm getting upset. That's the wrong thing to do, because if you do get upset and you do get mad, you're going to push him even further away.
Yeah. Hey, good luck. Right.
Because I feel like a lot of the things you're saying, I'm doing, but I'm not getting the response that I was expecting when I did it. So, I don't know. After
you put
year,
on that lingerie yet?
Yeah, that's key.
I do the lingerie. And trust me, Betty, I do the champagne and bubbles.
That's good. That's good, Colleen. That's good. Well, baby, we wish you the best of luck. And don't forget, if you're not busy tomorrow, come on out and join Keith Sweat. He's going to be at Mist up in Harlem on 116th Street. He's going to have a book signing. He has a brand-new book out. You probably need to get a hold of this book as well.
It sounds like a plan. Thanks so much, guys.
And get your man one, too.
Yeah, hey, that's right. You both can read it at separate times and together.
Oh, I'm going to try some new stuff tonight. But thanks so much. All right,
there you go, baby girl.
Thanks for calling.
All right. Bye-bye. Have a great evening.
We're inside the Quiet Storm. Thank you so much for watching online tonight. We're going to go back on air in a couple of minutes. Maybe we could squeeze in one quick call. Let's go with 7. Hello. Hello, hello.
Hello.
Hey.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
All right. Is this Mr. Whitaker?
What? Who?
Oh, I thought you. Hello?
Man, this is WBLS, brother. What's your name?
Yeah, my name is Kevin Brister. I thought they was talking about a healthy relationship.
Yeah, well, that's what we're talking about. I want Kevin to say hello to Keith Sweat, man.
How you doing, Kevin? How you doing?
Keith Sweat, hey, brother.
I'm good. How are you?
What's your question, man? We got to be real quick with it.
Well, my question is, what do you consider a healthy relationship? A lot of times, you know, men, especially men without no excuses or anything, but men without father figures or a mentor, they get into relationships growing up in their environment. They become a product of their environment, and they treat women as an object of their desire rather than, you know, trying to develop a healthy relationship or have a friendship with them before they get into anything intimate.
Keith, you want to take it?
Well, that's some men, not all men. That's number one. Number two, a healthy relationship is like you've seen Barack and Michelle.
Mm.
That's a healthy relationship, at least from what it looks like on the outside, because basically they hold hands, they smile at each other, they laugh in public. And when my man was messing with Barack, you saw her roll her eyes. That means she's a woman that's down for her man. That's a healthy relationship.
Yeah.
So if you can get to that point where you can hold your woman in public and don't care, kiss her in public and don't care, walk through the park and don't care, all those tell signs are healthy relationship signs.
Hey, brother, don't forget, Keith has a brand new book out. It's called Make It Last Forever, The Do's and Don'ts. It's a good read,
man. What's the name of it?
Make It Last Forever, The Do's and the Don'ts.
Okay.
Pick it up, baby.
Chef Ernest, we did your show last year at the Paradise. I think it was the Paradise before that closed up.
Oh,
I did a show with Chef Ernest, and I met Keith Sweat over there.
Okay.
And
okay,
off there on the Grand Concourse.
That's what's up,
in the
brother.
Bronx last year.
All right, my
he
brother.
He don't remember me, but, yeah, I remember him.
Thanks for calling,
all right, my
Kevin.
Brother. Thank you so much, man.
All right, then, brother.
Social media picture real quick before we go back on.
He fly, man. I ain't coming to suit and tie, man.
Uptown, baby.
Coming to suit and tie, so I'm a little, you know. It's cold out there. Hold on, let me fix the hat. You know what I'm saying? At least I can fix my hat.
107.5 WBLS. We're inside of the Quiet Storm tonight. Welcome to Confessions of Love, baby. Joining me tonight is my boy from Harlem World, Mr. Keith Sweat, who's in the building tonight. We got Harlem and we got Brooklyn.
That's right, babe.
Coming at you back to back.
Ain't getting no better than that.
Doesn't get any better.
Best of both worlds.
Keith has a brand new book out. That's right, a brand new book. It's his first book. I told Keith, get ready for book number two because I know that this book is going to fly off the chain. And I hope you're ready for the second book. I'm sure you have one already in you.
Well, you know what I'm going to do once we do the movie.
I think I do.
The second book will definitely will be coming. So if you got any screenwriters out there who want to do Make It Last Forever, the do's and the don'ts.
I like that.
Give me a script, baby.
There you go. That was a pitch if I've never heard a pitch before. Make It Last Forever, the do's and the don'ts. It's available. Matter of fact, Keith is going to be in Harlem. You're going back to your old stomping grounds.
Right, miss, on 116th Street between 6th and 5th Avenue.
What time tomorrow?
It starts at 7 o'clock, so make sure you come on out and spend a little time with me. Like the record I put on one of my albums with me and Charlie Wilson, spend a little time, baby.
Spend a little time. And, you know, it's going to be hosted tomorrow by Shayla and my mentor, Brother Vaughn Hopper.
Yeah, you need to be out there, too.
I should. But, you know, I got to work, brother. You know, okay, I got to work. Oh, you know, somebody got to hold down the fort. So I want to go to the love lines and get some reaction to you because the ladies in the tri-state are definitely itching to just say hello to you. So, Kim, say hello to Keith Sweat.
Hi, Keith. How are you?
Hello, Kim. How you doing, baby? What's going on with you?
I'm good. But my comment basically is I think relationships are something that you always work on. I was in a relationship with a younger guy than myself, and I realized that it was a phase that I was going through my life, but it wasn't something that I can look forward to and saying this is something that I can commit to because our lives were in different places and our minds were in different places. So I took it as an experience, and, you know, I thank you guys for allowing me to make that comment. So thank you very much.
Let me just be a little nosy.
Yes.
How many years apart were you and the younger man?
To be honest with you, it was like 14, 15 years.
You know what happened, right?
What happened, Keith?
I know exactly what happened.
I want to know what happened, Keith.
That sexual thing kicked in, baby. Oh.
He was a gentleman, basically, who, you know, he didn't have his head screwed on right. He was very cocky. He didn't know what to do with this woman because I'm all of that.
Can I ask you a question? Didn't you know that before you got into the relationship?
Actually, you know what? I think I was just at a rough time in my life, and I just was looking for something just to do. And it was the constant girls, you know, trying to speak to him while we were together and him flirting. I didn't appreciate that.
Well, I'm glad you found high ground, Kim.
Yes,
we appreciate
sir.
The call
yes,
tonight, baby. Thank you for calling.
I appreciate it, you guys.
All right, take care.
You guys have a good evening, and it's always a pleasure to speak to you.
Take care of yourself, Kim. Bye-bye.
You too. Bye-bye.
I've been in one of those situations before. Have you? Older woman, younger. Come on. Tell the truth and shame the devil. Man, this is back in the day, man. Come on. You can say it. It's not happening now.
Hey, it's all good. Yeah. You know. Come on, lady.
Okay.
Come on, baby. Where am I from?
You're from New York, baby.
All right, baby. Come on, man.
In this book that you have out, you talk about the concept of opposites attract.
Right.
For a while. But everyone is attracted to the opposite person. Like,
For
a while. But so how do we break out of that situation? You know, how do we break out of that? Because we want to try to make it last forever, baby.
Well, opposites attract for a while, and that's why if it's not something that you really truly want, you shouldn't get into it because you know it's only for a while.
Keith,
that's what most people do. They get into certain things, know it's not going to last. But, you know, like it's just like a brother who knows he's marrying a woman, and ladies, all of you are not this, who's a snake. Right. Well, you know the snake is going to bite you eventually. It's not when it's going to bite you. It's not whether it's going to bite you. It's when it's going to bite you.
Well, maybe she wants to be bitten, but not. She doesn't want the poisonous.
But
you know what I'm saying?
But you know, but we have a tendency to get into things knowing that it's not going to last, and that's the mistakes we do make. Now, I know when I'm getting into something knowing that I really don't want it to last and it's just a sexual rendezvous or situation. That's what I used to do back in the day. But I realized that was not making me a better man and it wasn't making me a better person. So I kind of had to stop doing those type of things.
His name is Keith Sweat. He is an author of Make It Last Forever, The Do's and the Don'ts. Let's go back to 1996. I think you might remember this joint. Twisted. That young lady could have been twisted, come to think of it. But I'm not going to get into that. Look, if you'd like to talk with Keith tonight, 212-545-1075. We're inside of Confessions of Love with Keith Sweat tonight, baby. So call us up. Let's get that one-to-one going. Welcome inside of our online chat with Brother Keith Sweat. Keith, you haven't stopped moving. I think that was one of the first things that kind of talked about when you came in tonight. Keith stays very, very busy. You said you do at least 50 shows a year.
I do at least 50 shows a year. Yeah.
And this year, it may very well go up because you're adding some international
travel. Last year, I did Paris, London, Germany. Last year in Africa, Nigeria, and Johannesburg, South Africa last year. This year, I'm on my way to Brazil. I got to perform there, and I'm doing Dubai on the end of March, and they're making myself and Teddy Riley ambassadors of Dubai.
That is a wonderful thing.
For a music conference that will be there once a year. So you're doing that.
Well, you know what, brother? I won't make it this year, but I'm praying for next year. I need to stay connected with you, brother.
Okay, and, no problem.
I definitely like to attend the following year, because if it's going to be a music conference.
It's a music conference.
Then you're going to need some panelists.
Yeah. Okay, no problem.
And I need to be one of your panelists. That's what I'm going to say.
No problem.
We are talking with Keith. Keith is the author of a hot new, his first debut book. It's called Make It Last Forever, The Do's and the Don'ts, and it's available. So please make sure you get it. I'm sure it's available on Amazon.com. But you know what? I'm sure you would want to get up close and personal with Keith, unlike a concert. So tomorrow, if you're in New York, in Harlem on 116th Street, it's a spot called Mist. And Keith, you'll be there around 6 o'clock.
I'll be there around 6 o'clock.
Signing the brand new book.
There you go, baby.
It'll be right there for you. And, you know, you can meet Keith, take a picture with Keith, I'm assuming. And I'm sure there's going to be a Q&A session.
Definitely. We're going to discuss the book and do whatever we need to do to get you hooked up.
You know, when we get back on air, of course, we'll go take some calls online. So if you're calling 212-545-1075, we'll hope to get you a call in just a moment.
Right.
But when we go back on air, we're going to talk about the pleasers.
Okay.
You know, because that's a big thing. You know, people who please and people who don't please.
Right.
So I know you covered that pretty extensively on the in the book, so I want to definitely deal with that. Let's go to the line. Let's go to line one to Donnell. Donnell.
Yes.
Thanks for calling in tonight. Say hello to Keith Sweat.
Hi, Keith.
Hello, how are you?
I'm well. How are you?
I'm great.
Question or comment?
I just called in. I heard that he was going to be on tonight, and I am like one of his biggest fans. So I just wanted to call in and say hi and see how he was doing.
I'm great. Thank you for checking on me. I appreciate that.
Now, when you say you're one of his biggest fans, you have to be a little more in depth with me. What does that mean? Does that mean that you own everything that he's put out?
Just about. Like, I've been trying to – I'm actually going to see him when he comes back to New York in April. So, you know, I've been – you know, looking him up and following him and all that good stuff.
You haven't been stalking me, have you, baby?
No, I would never do that. I would never do that.
I saw somebody in my bushes the other night in Atlanta.
No, that wasn't me.
You sure, baby?
But I just wanted to call in and say hi.
All right.
Hi. Well, make sure, obviously you have supported him and bought all of his albums, but you now know he's an author, so you may want to pick up the book because I think you'll find it to be quite interesting. Are you in a relationship right now?
No, I'm not.
You hesitated. What's that
no,
about?
I'm not.
Okay, well, go to truelovemeets.com, baby.
Here you go. Yeah,
let me hook you up.
Now tell her about True.
Well, truelovemeets.com. In writing the book, you know, it's no sense of me writing the book telling you what you should do and what you shouldn't do in your relationship. if I'm not going to give you the hookup. Well, the hookup is the hookup is going to my dating site, which is truelovemeets.com, and getting yourself hooked up.
Well, thank you for that information.
Okay. This brother is covering all
all ground.
So, Donnell, thanks for calling. And if you get a chance tomorrow, join Keith up in Harlem at on 116th Street. Okay.
I will try. Thank you very much, and you guys have a wonderful evening.
You have a blessed night too. All right, bye bye.
Thank you.
Let's go to number four. Salima.
Hello.
Hello, Salima. How are you?
Hi, how are you?
How you doing, Salima?
Say hello to Keith.
I'm fine.
Okay, where you calling from, baby?
I need you to turn, you got to turn the volume down, baby, because you're getting confused.
Okay, right? I think I have, the computer.
You got it?
Yeah, turn it down, turn it down, Salima.
Salima, where you calling from, boo-boo?
Okay.
Where you calling from?
Now I can hear you.
Where you calling from, Salima?
Salima, please. Just talking to the phone. Just talk. Forget about that. Just talking to the phone, okay?
Okay, I'm calling from Queens.
Okay, what can we do for you tonight, Salima?
Okay, my question is, come, Lenny, stop laughing at me.
You're listening to the computer, so you have to turn it down. Turn the computer down, please.
Okay, I'm getting next one. My question is for Keith Sweat. What do you do? What kind of advice you can give someone that is doing everything, you know, working out, looking good, and still not even getting, you know, someone to, you know, pay attention to her in the way that she would like?
Do you have a man?
Hello?
Do you have a man?
If I have a man?
Do you have a man, yes.
No.
Okay.
Well. I have a lot of friends. And
you have a lot
they
of
don't
friends.
Take me serious. They want to hang out with me or whatever, but they don't really take me serious.
All right, well, you know what you need to do? You go to truelovemeets.com.
No, I'm serious.
I'm serious. I have my own dating site. Because actually, obviously, you're not running into the right men. And, you know, and they're not ready to be serious, even though you're ready to be serious.
That's
good. Hello, can you hear me?
No, I can't.
I said, obviously, you're not running into the right men.
Hello?
Yeah, Salima, you're going to have to hang up the phone, baby.
Oh, I lost the call.
Yeah, we will call you back, baby.
Wow, but yeah, she seems like she's not running into the right men, and I'm assuming now, is there a screening process on truelovemeets.com?
Yeah, on truelovemeets.com, there's definitely a screening process. I try to tell people, you get what you the way you look, the way you put your profile up is very important, because the people that you come in contact with on my dating site are those who look at it, and you know. I think sometimes people don't put their best foot forward.
This is very true.
And that's a problem. It's like this young lady was just talking about. She's the men she's with. They're not taking her seriously. I don't think she's even dealing with the right men. To be honest with you, I think sometimes people, you know, they deal with people who are not really being into a relationship. And I think that's what she's doing, because she says she's working out, she's looking good, she's doing all the things she should do for a man to want to be attracted to. And I don't know what kind of men she's
attracted to,
or she's even appealing to or trying to appeal to. And that might be a problem in itself.
So do you, obviously with you starting up this online dating site, you're not opposed to people trying that measure now in terms
you know
of
what?
Trying to find
a you know, I always tell people, I think when MySpace came out and Facebook came out, that was just a way of people trying to hook up with each other. I mean, real talk, even though people say, well, I'm doing it for business. I was on there looking for, like, hold up, this girl is bad. Hit me up if this is really
and
you.
And I'm sure some relationships got started like that. Sure.
So the dating site is the way to just cut through all the bull.
Gotcha.
To be honest with you, hey, this is I'm looking to meet somebody. I'm looking to date. I'm not looking for, you know, anything other than that. So
get to
that's
know.
What it is.
Yeah, let's go to the lines. Let's go to the lines again. Let's punch up anyone.
What you say, Lenny?
Anyway, how are you tonight?
I'm okay. How are you?
I'm good. What's your name?
My name is Kiara. I called you last night. Don't you remember?
Kiara. Kiara, how are you? Yes, I got your voice now. Well, say hello to Keith Sweat, Kiara.
Hi, Keith Sweat. Oh, my gosh. I love your sexy voice. I love your music. Just everything about you, Keith Sweat.
The way you just...
It's a miracle to be talking to you.
How you doing? But the way you told Lenny, I called you last night. You don't remember? It's like, hold on, what y'all got going on?
No, no, there's nothing going on, Keith.
I'm just messing with you, man. I'm just messing with you. I'm just having...
I know you have a question for Keith, though.
I'm just messing with you, man. The way she said it, though. We wine up in here and
you know, we're keeping it sexy, growing
it sexy.
It sexy. That's all we're doing, man. You know? So, Kiara, what is your question or comment for Keith?
Okay. Keith said, I'm a Scorpio, and someone that I know, they're a Pisces. They, you know, they want to get in a relationship with me, but they're too sensitive. Like, the sensitivity about them is that they want to know everything I do. They want to go everywhere I go. And, I mean, I can't take that.
You must be a bad girl.
No, I'm not a bad girl.
No, I don't mean it in. Oh, listen, bad.
I know what you're talking about.
Fine, sexy.
Right now, you know, I'm 24 years old and I'm ready for a committed relationship. I'm
not ready
for a boyfriend because remember, boyfriend has an end. Husband.
Oh, that's in a year.
Wow.
I want something everlasting, like your book is about to come out and say, and I really want to get it and read it because I want an everlasting relationship.
Listen to you, baby.
I don't want it to come to an end.
All right. Deep. Lenny, you got this one, babe?
What I would think that you should do, and I'm not a guru like Keith Sweat, but what I think you should do is you need to find people that are compatible to what you like in a person. Obviously, you don't want a person to be watching your every move. You want to, without trust in any kind of relationship, it's just not going to be able to be a lasting relationship at all. So there has to be a certain level of trust, and obviously maybe to some of the men that you have selected to go out with, maybe they're a little insecure within themselves.
There you go.
And by them being insecure, they are looking at your every move. So I think you need men who are confident, who know what
and
they're about.
The thing about it is that I don't go out a lot.
Let me ask
the
you a question.
About it is that
are you a social?
I'm a person. I go to school because I'm about to go to school and be a guidance counselor for drug abuse.
But let me ask you a question. Are you a social butterfly?
No, I'm not.
You're not a social butterfly. Well, you know what? Because some men have a problem with a woman being a social butterfly. Mm. And have you ever given him a reason to believe or think that you're doing anything outside of what you should be doing?
No, because me and him, we are like best friends. It's like we'll be walking outside and somebody will look at me and they'd be like, damn, she looks good. And then he'll catch your eye at them. And then I'm like, it's their eyes. They can
look. Well, you know what? Let me tell you something. Well, you're dealing with a very insecure man. And that's the problem. You have to deal with someone who's confident within themselves. Because when you're dealing with someone who's insecure, that causes problems. And you know, and I tell people this all the time. If you're dealing with someone who's very insecure, you're going to have a problem on your hands. Because when you... going out with your mama or your friend or anybody else, that man might be lurking right around the corner. So believe me.
I'm telling you.
Believe me. I don't think, and I'm not trying to put any salt on my man game, but right. I already see that relationship is a doomed relationship. So, you know, and that's the point of when I say do's and the don'ts, that's the don't.
Yeah.
Don't do that. So you need to deal with someone who you know is secure within themselves, and someone who will say to you, "Let me tell you when you know you got a good man. When the man tells you, hey, girl, go ahead on out with your girlfriends. Just call me. Let me know you good. Let me know you safe. Mm. You know, and those type of things. Or he don't mind you going on trips with your girlfriends. He's secure with that. Mm. Or those type of things. That's when you know you got a good man. That's when you know that man trusts you. Without and there's hands down and there's no problems in that relationship.
Make sure you get that book.
Exactly.
Get that book, Kiara. And if you get a chance tomorrow, join Keith Sweat up in Harlem, right? At Mist on 116th Street at 6:00.
No problem. Keith,
all right, baby.
It was a wonderful time talking to you. Thank you for your
good
advice. And both of you, you have a blessed night. And Lenny Green, if you can play Nobody from Keith Sweat for me again tonight, boo.
You like that song, huh? Gotcha. All right,
you can love you gotcha. Like me, nobody.
Thanks for calling, Kiara.
All right, thanks.
Bye-bye. Let's take another one. Welcome inside the Quiet Storm. What's your name?
Hi, my name is Michelle Seabrook.
Michelle, please turn your radio down. Say hello
to Keith. Okay, I just turned it down.
Say hello to Keith Sweat.
This is Lenny.
This is Lenny, yes.
Hi, excuse my voice. I have laryngitis. And when I spoke to you about 3 weeks ago. I was talking to you about Fred Bugs and whatnot.
Oh, I got you. Okay, well,
yeah.
Michelle, say hello to Keith Sweat.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to do.
Oh, wait, well, he's listening to you.
How you doing, Michelle?
He's listening?
How you been drinking?
Hi, Keith.
How you doing,
Mr.
baby?
Sweat.
How you doing? We've been drinking wine up in here. You must be having, you must have some yourself.
No,
baby.
I've been calling you back because I was sick and I just woke up.
Okay.
And
well,
I said, okay.
I just want to make sure you're good, boo.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm okay. Now, is he listening? He's listening to me now?
You're talking to him, babe. You're talking,
oh, I'm talking to
him. Yeah, I know.
Keith,
I know.
How are you?
How you doing? So
love you. I remember when you did the Quiet Storm.
Okay, that's well, right, well, I'm drinking wine.
He's still, he's still doing radio. He's all over the country, man.
Keith,
yes.
I knew your mom. You know how we do up there in Harlem. I live in Springfield Gardens, Queens.
Okay.
But I used to come up there. To get my do done, okay, at the hairdresser place where your mom worked, across 124th Street and Adams Place.
I remember that well.
Yes, okay. And you came in the shop one day, and I just missed you also.
Okay.
Because the women were talking, and they said, the Keith Sweat was in here.
Yeah,
you
my
know?
Mom told me
I
you
said,
were there.
Oh, my God, I can't believe that I missed him.
Well,
okay?
Hopefully you don't miss him tomorrow. You know, he's going to be in Harlem tomorrow, okay?
Come on
now,
down.
Now, that's what I missed. I was trying to catch that. We're in Harlem.
It's at Miss
116th
Street between 5th and 6th. So make sure you come on down and check
116th
me out.
Street between
5th and 6th, baby.
5th and 6th.
Okay.
Okay.
I look forward to seeing you.
I'm going to try because I feel better. So okay. I'm going to try to be there.
Okay.
Okay. 6 o'clock. 6 o'clock,
and
be there, okay?
I'm going to take a picture with you, too.
All right. You can take a picture with me.
But come ready to get the book, though, all right? Don't just come for the picture.
No,
come for the book.
I would love to have that book. Yes. That's another thing, too.
Don't
worry about it.
But before you come out, make sure you're well. I don't want you giving nobody that
you don't want the cooties, in other words, right?
It's a pleasure to talk to you.
Thanks for calling,
baby. Take care of yourself.
I love you.
Baby. Love
and
you
tell
too,
Lenny,
baby.
I love him too.
He's right here listening.
Tell Lenny I was at the old timer show at the Beacon this weekend.
I hope you had a good time, Mama.
It was phenomenal.
Outstanding.
Oh, I carried on.
I know you did.
Yes, it did. Okay.
Have a good
love,
night.
Love you guys. All right.
Love you too, love baby. You too.
All right. Bye.
Give me one more. One more. Real quick. WBLS. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Hi.
Can you turn that radio down for me, baby, please?
I'm doing that. What's up, Lynn? Gwen.
Who's this?
How you?
Who's this?
Gwen.
Hey, Gwen.
From Best Die, baby.
All right, do or die. All right. say hello.
Yeah, I'm sorry I missed that party. My friend John went.
Well, that's okay. Hold on, Gwen. Hello? Okay, well, Gwen is out for tonight. Hey, look, I appreciate you guys watching online. We try, Gwen. We try.
Listen, we're having fun here online. We're just having fun, man.
That's what we're doing. We're going to go back on air. But before we go back on air, man, you're coming back to perform in New York.
Yeah, I'm coming back in April to perform.
Can you keep me abreast? Oh, I mean, man. Being so this is our first official meeting of sitting down since 1988. You know what I'm saying?
Well,
I'm always in New York.
I come to and perform at BB King's every year, so this will be another year I'll be at BB King's. So I'm coming back to do that in April as well. So,
you know what, ladies, he can't take all of you. I'll be right there on the side. I know it's heartbreaking for you, and I know I'm a second fiddle, but I'll be right there on the side.
Okay.
The new book is available, and it is a good read, and I suggest that you read it. You should read it if you're in between relationships, definitely if you're in relationships as well.
If you in between, like you said, if you're in one, it's a good book. It's definitely will enlighten you.
It will. If
you want to do any kind of soul searching, this book is good for that.
And I'm glad you hit right on the point, because what I want to touch on real quick, in this book you talk about getting yourself together first. Mm-hmm. Why is that so quintessential?
Because, you know, a lot of people should not even be in a relationship. You know, some people are not meant to be in a relationship, and you know, they just do it because it's something to do.
But what about the ones who should, who are in the relationship and should be out of the relationship, and they don't want to leave because of the most common problem, which is they don't want to be alone?
Well, that's true too, and they need to stop. Those people need to not be selfish, because I feel that's self, being selfish, and you're only concerned about yourself anyway, and the relationship is doomed after a while anyway. So some people should not even be in a relationship. Some people are not meant to be in a relationship, because basically you have to understand, you have to give up a lot of yourself, you know, not some of yourself in a relationship, but a lot of yourself and the other person as well. So if two people are not willing to give of themselves, that's not good for the relationship. You know, there's no way that a woman is going to allow herself to give 85% and a man is giving her 15%. You know, this is like Teddy said, it's 50-50.
It's 50-50.
Not 60-40, 70-30, but it's 50-50.
Gotta be balanced.
You know what I'm saying? And if it's not that, it's nothing.
He is beyond the relationship guru. He is the singer, the songwriter, the entrepreneur. Please explain once again for those who might be interested in looking for love beyond this book. They can go to this new online dating site,
TrueLoveMeets.com. And fellas, I'm getting more ladies than guys. I need some help, baby. I cannot handle all these women.
I don't understand why the fellas are so shy, man. I really
don't. Because you know what it is? Fellas, they don't want to put themselves out there. But it's nothing wrong with having a conversation. And, you know, because you might not find what you want in your city. It might be in Houston. It might be in Chicago. It might be in L.A. It just might not be where you're at.
Have you dealt with personally in your lifespan long distance relationships? And do you like them or do
I'm,
you not?
I'm
like
dealing
them?
With one now.
Really?
But I'm secure, you know, because she makes me feel secure.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, she comes when she has time. I started to say she comes when I
when you ask her to go.
tell her. But you know that didn't sound no, like, that didn't girl. Sound
I
good.
Got you. I got you.
You know what I'm saying? But you know, I mean, I like it like that because I'm so busy.
Gotcha.
And it allows me to do me, and she's doing her, and when we get together, we do us.
Right. That's cute.
So it's good, you know, and honestly, I wouldn't have never found that if I were not traveling. But for those that don't travel like I do,
like me,
you know,
right.
Then you're going.
I hate those long distance. Unlike Keith, I hate long distance relationships.
But it can be great, because when someone is on top, see relationships are like this. When someone is on top of you all the time. And some brothers actually feel like this, and some sisters feel like this, who are corporate in corporate America. They might feel like, man, I need a little break. I need a little break. So if you have that balance and you know who you are and what you are and what you're about, that can sometimes be a good balance.
Interesting. Keith Sweat, baby, Inside the Quiet Storm. We're going live on air, but thank you for watching online tonight. We really do appreciate it. Don't forget tomorrow.
Tomorrow, Miss Babies. 6th and 5th. Be there.
16th. This is marathon, Brother Keith. This is marathon radio.
I don't do marathons.
107.5 WVLS. This is The Quiet Storm. It is an honor and a pleasure to be sitting down with my brother Keith Sweat tonight, who has... made City College very, very proud. What was your major in City College?
Communications.
No joke.
No joke.
Wow, man. You definitely covered the spectrum, man.
You know, I had to do what I had to do. I had a strict mom.
I understand.
She didn't
bro.
Play. She did not play. Everybody in Harlem knows Miss Sweat. From the
like that, huh?
And just like that. She did not. She did not play. So
now, wait, are you the only child?
Now, I have two older brothers and two younger sisters. So, you know.
You're middle.
I'm a brat.
So you were spoiled a little bit.
She knew I was the spoiled one. It was like no doubt that I was going to be what I was going to be, how I was going to be that, when I was going to be that. No doubt.
Keith is the author of his debut book called Make It Last Forever, The Do's and the Don'ts. Tomorrow at 6 o'clock, you're traveling back to your old stomping grounds.
Well, tomorrow I'm traveling back to my old stomping grounds. And let me just say this. If it wasn't for New York and Harlem and KISS and BLS, you know, and I would not even be the man or the person that I am today. So I really have to shout out to my hometown because
yes, sir.
That this is where I got the balance, the ability to do what I, you know, growing up in New York, honestly, man, if you can't, and it's a very true saying, if you can't make it here, you can't make it anywhere.
Yes, sir.
Because growing up in the Grand Projects, where I grew up at, you know, apartment 3I.
That's what's
and up. I would look down the block, two blocks away, and there was the Apollo growing up. And I would remember walking them streets of many a days and looking up at the Apollo and say, one day.
I hear that.
Just one day. Just if I get one shot.
You're going to be in there.
I'm going to be in there. And when it happened, it just happened. And that's why I tell people don't give up on your dreams. Because when it happened, it just happened. It was like I never knew it was going to happen like it happened. And my first album with Teddy Riley sold 4 million. And it was ridiculous because, you know, at the time that me and him did that album, brothers were not allowed to write and produce their own records. And me and him did that whole album. No help, just you, him and I. And it blew up. Second album blew up. And by the grace of God, it was like, it has led me to where I am now. And I've had a great, great career. And I want to thank each and every one of you out there for blessing me, because it is truly a blessing that I'm here and I'm still doing what I'm doing.
And I'm glad that you are, brother. I mean, you have definitely helped many
have
many
babies.
Situations. I'm sure there's a few babies that are because of you as well. But I want to thank you for your body of creativeness.
Thank you, man.
And I know you ain't finished yet.
I hope not.
No, you're not finished yet. So we look forward to more opportunities and more things for you to cover. I'm going to hold him at bay, ladies, for just a little bit, because I want to get out just one question, because I know this question that I'm about to ask him that's in this book, you definitely want to know about it. But let's get back into another one of your favorite slow jams tonight. Appreciate the call in many ways. And once again, big shout out to Brother Smokey Robinson, who checked in with us just a little before you came. He's celebrating his 72nd birthday today.
Oh, my
today,
God. Man. Yeah. Oh, man, definitely.
God bless you, Smokey.
Lately, I have had the strangest feeling, with no vivid reason here to find. Yet the thought of losing you's been hanging round my mind. Far more frequently you're wearing perfume, with you say no special place to go. But when I ask will you be coming back soon, you don't know, never know. While I'm a man of many wishes, hope my premonition misses. But what I really feel, my eyes won't let me hide, 'cause they always start to cry. 'Cause this time slowly picking me apart, trying to tell myself I had no reason with your heart.
Just the other night while you were sleeping, I vaguely heard you whisper someone's name. But when I ask you of the thoughts you're keeping, you just say, nothing's changed.